Primer's panel 1 consists of 8 types of primers, and Primer's 2A, 3 types, and Primer's panel 2B, 5 types.
Stop. Don't just read. Instead, look and then explain to us. Don't give the same exact sentence that you have on the PowerPoint slide, okay? Try that.
So, this the combination of these three primers will finally give me the result of the genotypes of these Brucella isolates. So, this is...
I have a question for you. Why did you use this specific combination of primers and not any other combination? What made you to decide on this combination?
Because according to research, these 16 primers is the primers that will give us the exact Brucella genotypes, which is specific for this type of material.
According to which research?
Look
at Francis Saloma. Her eyebrows are, she's frowning because she cannot hear you.
No confidence,
yeah? Okay, let's put a stop to this. Sorry, eh? Let's start all over again. Don't look so timid. Don't look scared. Instead, talk to us. Be excited to talk about your result. Never mind about what you have written here. Okay? Don't read all this because we can read also. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, I'm excited to report the result and the findings of
Title slide.
Sorry, eh? Okay, talk about this first.
Okay. Ladies and gentlemen.
Louder.
Ladies and gentlemen, today I would like to report on my findings of my research entitled Multiple Locus Variable Tandem Repeat Analysis Genotyping of...
Look.
Multiple Locus Variable Tandem Repeat Analysis Genotyping of Human Brucella Isolate Simulation.
Ladies and gentlemen, a very good afternoon to all of you. Louder.
Ladies and gentlemen, a very good afternoon to all of you.
I'm very excited today.
Because you have given me the opportunity to report my research findings entitled Multiple Locus Variable Tandem Repeat Analysis Genotyping of Human Brucella Isolates Stimulation.
My findings on the research. Multiple locus variable tandem repeat analysis. MLVA. On the genotyping of human Brucella isolates in Malaysia. The grant for the research
was awarded in 2012.
And the amount of the grant awarded was
200,000 ringgit.
And the agreed duration for the completion of this project was?
Completion duration for this project was 2 to 3 years.
3 years. 3 years?
2 years.
2 years. I am happy to report that I've completed this project.
I'm happy to report that I have completed this project.
On budget.
On budget.
And on schedule.
On budget and on schedule.
Please allow me.
To talk about my findings.
I see all those not written anywhere, you see? But it's good to report when you are completed, then you go back to tell them that you are on budget, you are on time, okay? And after that, continue. And the rest. Okay. Continue.
The objectives of this research.
Just say, these were the objectives.
These were the objectives. First.
Which was to determine and to identify. Wait, go back to the next slide, this previous slide. I am happy to report
that my project
has successfully delivered on these objectives.
Now let me define what is MLB.
This is the definition. I said this is the definition of MLVA.
This is the definition of MLVA.
Move.
Can I interrupt?
Yes.
One point. Smart opinion.
Yes. But you see, this is a vast improvement already, because earlier she couldn't stop giggling. I agree, but I don't want to point out to that fact, because this is vast improvement already. 1,000% improvement from the giggling. So to me, I'm satisfied already. It's just the voice and the delivery of the content, okay? So if you have a slide, just say, this is the definition. Stop for a while, allow them to read, and then you move on. Move on. You don't have to read. Okay. No one.
So actually, how long should I give a while? Maybe for 1 minute, and then before I go to the next. If let's say when it comes to definition.
Okay, this is, you can say this, yeah? This is the definition of the method I have used, as well as the number of the tandem repeats I've used in my project. Say that.
This is the method which I have used for my.
This is the definition.
This is the definition of the method which I have used for my research.
As well as the determination of the number of tandem repeats. Move on, that's right. Please let me tell you what I have discovered in the research. Please let me report to you.
What I have discovered.
Nah. Talk about the findings. Never mind about the method and all this. Then result. Okay. Louder.
Before I show you my findings, let me tell you a little bit first on the results of my research findings.
Okay.
When it comes to MLVA, there there are 16, which I've used 16 primers for my research, and these 16 primers will actually give a profile.
Louder?
Will actually give a profile which we call it MLVA profile, which consists of 16
Integers.
16 integers, which is according to the primers, the three panels, panel 1, 2A, and 2B. So after getting these results, I will compare to the... I have compared the our Brucella strains against the Brucella MLVA database in the website, which... Which you can reach at this
mlva.upsud.fr.
And finally, these research findings also gave me a dendrogram, which will show us the percentage of similarity among the Brucella isolates. So this is the
example
of the dendrogram
which I have produced
from my research.
What is interesting to note is that
interesting to know from my research proposal, which I have met my two objectives, was the genetic diversity of my local Brucella isolates, and also the genotypes of our local isolates.
As a result of the research, I have discovered that
In Malaysia,
there are four types
of genotypes, which is genotype 6, 42, 43, and 44. And genotype 6 belongs to the Brucella Swiss Biova 1 group, whereas genotype 42, 43, and 44 belongs to the Brucella melitensis of the Mediterranean group.
This is interesting. Because we have never known this fact before.
It will have a great impact
on
epidemiological studies, which will help which one of the important features will be
molecular trace back analysis. Yelah, that's why I ask you for confirmation. I don't quite understand this, but okay. This allows us
to track the source of the infection. Outbreak.
For example, genotype 43 origins from Middle East. Mediterranean. The Mediterranean, isn't that interesting? Do we import any Mediterranean cattle or goat? come on, continue. Just talk like that. Just have a conversation. Come on.
Genotype 42, 43, and 44.
Three quarters of the genotypes in Malaysia. 75%.
Were found to be common
in the Mediterranean.
In the Mediterranean.
Yeah. This implies.
This implies that
we have imported this genotype.
We have imported this genotype
from the Mediterranean. I don't know if this valid or not lah. Just discuss lah. Yelah, yeah, okay lah. That's what I said. We have imported this from the Mediterranean. Yeah, from the Mediterranean. No. Just talk about that. Just talk.
The goods were imported from the Mediterranean.
There is a high possibility
that the goods
were. Must be a male goat then. Okay.
Potential it could be because we didn't know the marker of the goats to comes from where. Because initially we have a marker, but it could be
the ancestors.
This points out to the fact that it is important for us to screen all imported goats.
And also the goat handler.
This points out to the fact that the goats must be screened, it's important to screen the imported goats.
So we don't introduce new strains of
Brucella isolates into our population.
Local goat population.
Could it be that we already have this and we share same as Mediterranean? It's not important?
So it correlates. Bukan Middle Eastern and Mediterranean not the same. Mediterranean, Greece, Turkey.
Mungkin kalau Bangla the possible ini Mediterranean.
Mediterranean strain, you know.
Australia.
Tak ada. It's Mediterranean. It's interesting because right nowadays we import goats from Argentina, from South Africa. But how the Mediterranean one?
And then you can also compare what for other countries. Do they have the same genotype as us?
Or they have from different, like for the genotype 43, it is found in certain countries like Turkey and Spain. Whereas genotype 42, you have it in